Don't Look Up is one of those rare movies nowadays that takes a topic that is contemporary in our society and makes a brilliant satire that has a lot of jokes and a lot of things to make fun of in our present world. And that is movies that recently have been done with Borat and with other things, but I think this movie did a great job with a concept that I think is really important, and we'll analyze why today. So Don't Look Up is the story of a pair of scientists that discover a meteor that's going to hit the Earth in a couple of months. So they go on like a mission to warn the world and basically prevent this. So along the way, they face the president of the United States, they face the media, they face a lot of different groups of people who would like flat out ignore the meteor even exists. And they go basically on this journey of discovering just how idiotic the world is. And it's pretty much basically a reflection of our society today. I think this movie is just so brilliant in so many ways because it takes all those concepts that people have been battling with during the last few years around misinformation or on how the media uses all those things to basically distract people and instead of focusing on the real issues. And I think it did it in a great way. So the movie stars Leonardo DiCaprio and Jennifer Lawrence in the lead roles, but also Jonah Hill did a great job. But those three, I think, were the best actors in the movie. But everybody did an amazing job. I think this movie was really well acted. It is very funny despite the depressing subject matter, but that's the reason why I enjoyed it. And it's just so funny to see like all these people interacting. So you focus on scientists, you focus on also the corporate part of the world, like the government and the corporations. I think they're both two like big worlds that have the power to like cause a lot of damage in our world. So I really like that they didn't like shy away from that part of the movie, and it's just done in a brilliant way. So let's analyze it part by part, starting with the story and from the beginning. Also, this is a good point to announce that I'm gonna go into spoilers. So if you haven't seen the movie, you don't want it spoiled, please skip straight ahead or watch another video because I'm gonna go into spoilers. It's hard to talk about the movie without going into spoilers, especially towards the ending. So yeah, but anyways, let's go on with the story. So Don't Look Up is this like starts off with the scientists. They discover the meteor, and the first thing they do is they go with the government. So the first basically their first instinct is to be like, okay, you know, the US government has to do something. And it's like a really interesting way how they parodied our previous administration, at least in the United States, with the president played by Meryl Streep. I think that was brilliantly done, and I'll explain why. And the way they took these topics of the president really only caring about the poll numbers and about, like, you know, getting reelected over what is actually going on and over the science is just so reflective of reality. And that's just one part of the story. Then they go to the media and nobody cares. It's a really brilliant scene where involving like Ariana Grande and a couple other things before the scientists have to present their findings. And it's just a really awesome and funny and depressing way to show how people just care about entertainment and they really want it's I like the message I got from the movie is that people nowadays kind of like don't want to think about all the horrible things happening or about climate change, which is kind of like the main allegory the movie focuses on, is on the whole thing of around climate change. But how people don't want to listen to that or hear about that is also with things like animal rights, you know, things happening on the other side of the world that are just, you know, really hard to comprehend. So they just kind of get distracted by entertainment to the point where it's negative towards society. So the way all these topics like intertwine with each other and lead to other scenes are great. I think everything in the movie flows pretty well. It's really great acted. It has a lot of jokes. I think it makes the best out of the, you know, the material, which is basically the absurdity of our world, or kind of like going the South Park approach. It feels like a South Park live action movie in a lot of ways. And also this is reflected through one of the most entertaining and also like important characters in the movie, which is Peter Isherwell. So this character is basically like an amalgamation of all the different billionaire tech CEOs we have in our world today. So that would be like Mark Zuckerberg, Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, Bill Gates. See, I saw like a little sprinkles of Bill Gates in there, but this character is just so it's like that character you love to hate or you hate to love because Peter Isherwell plays a really big role in the story because the message Don't Look Up gives is that corporations have a really big role to play in our society. Even if people don't think it that way, I think they have a lot of influence, even more influence than governments. Their corporations and companies out there have more, literally more money and power than some governments, like some small countries. So that's something that really, really needs to be taken into account while taking situation, like making decisions, you know, knowing who to vote, like who these people are being influenced by. And just the way like his influence and his money and his power like takes an effect onto the whole plan to save the world, it's just really depressing and really reflective of reality, how money is sometimes is put over a lot of different things. So that is, I think like a really good thing in the story that was focused on. So I really liked the whole story with Peter Isherwell, and especially towards the ending, how everything wraps up together. I thought it was depressing, so we'll talk about that next. So at the end of the movie, all the characters just basically realize they failed everything they did in order to save the world and to deflect the meteor and to generate attention just basically falls apart because of several things. I noticed like misinformation. I noticed like previous beliefs, like a lot of biases that people had. Like there was a lot of just political discussion. There's also like a really small scene with Chris Evans where he wears like a pin, because there's like half the people that are like saying look up at the meteor, like look, there it is, it's right there, just look up and see the meteor. And then the other people, which is a really obvious parody of a certain group of, you know, political advocates, that had like the don't look up pin. And then Chris Evans is like, oh, you know, I just kind of like focus on looking up and don't looking down, because, you know, we got to be united as a country. So that, I thought that was a really kind of like really subtle jab at like centrists, and people will like take the middle ground when like one issue is really towards one side, like the truth and the, you know, the most common sense thing to do. And I really like this movie. I think it has a lot to think about, a lot to discuss. I think it's a really good thing to discuss this movie with other people. But I know a lot of people also didn't like it. They thought it was like too on the nose, too, you know, like obvious, too like non-subtle about the things it was criticizing. But I think those are the same reasons they didn't like it are the same reasons I really enjoyed the movie. So yeah, I really like Don't Look Up. And I think it's one of the best movies of the year. So it's also, it's really important. It's a brilliant satire. And it's also funny as hell. It's really entertaining, has a lot of rewatchability value. So yeah, overall, I really enjoyed the movie. I think I'm going to give it a 90 out of 100. I think it was really well executed. It was really great. And yeah, that's pretty much all my thoughts on it. And I know there's a lot to discuss. I could probably go like scene by scene on the movie, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to do that over the years, because I'm probably going to rewatch it over and over and notice things that I haven't previously noticed. I've watched it twice already, and the second time around, I noticed like a lot of details, a lot of like dialogue that I didn't see the first time. So that's something to do later on. But yeah, I really like the movie. Please go watch it. It's on Netflix. So yeah, that's everything for today. So have a great day, everybody, and I'll see you around.